These children spent 20 years without walking. They couldn't even move by themselves, and parents decided to lock them inside for 20 years. But after Afrimax's visit to them, life started changing. They got support with basic necessities and some money, then took these children to hospitals. And those who couldn't even make a single step by themselves have started to walk by leaning on people or the objects, and were promising that soon they might walk on their feet for the first time. It was all good until when their health conditions worsened again and they failed to walk miserably. But what happened to these children? Were they poisoned as many people thought? Or else is it being possessed by some evil spirits? You would not believe this if it was not recorded. These children couldn't even recognize themselves from their own names, years of age, to name but a few. And due to people trying to insult or mock them with some negative comments, parents decided to lock them, and they've been locked for more than 20 years now. We visit this family in this remote village, and they tell us what exactly happened to their children. After tying the knot in 1979, this couple's love bore fruit and they were blessed with 10 beautiful children. The village celebrated their growing family and life seemed like a wonderful picture painted with love and laughter. However, fate had different plans in the store for them. Tragedy struck the family when many of the children succumbed to a mysterious and deadly illness. Four of the remaining children began to show signs of an unusual disease. They left their bodies weak and trembling. Their limbs would shake uncontrollably, and it became impossible for them to perform even the simplest tasks like holding a cup of water or walking a few steps. Parents say they were born normal without any health issue or abnormality. And at the age of 7, that's when they started developing this disorder, not being able to hold anything, stand upright, walk, or even memorize something. Lack of enough money to cover hospital bills, extreme poverty as a result of unemployment by their parents due to having not gone to school in the early years are factors that hindered parents to take their children to the hospital, says their mother. As the years passed, children's condition worsened and the parents could only watch helplessly as their beloved offsprings suffered. The children were unable to attend school and missed out on the joys of childhood. Their bright eyes that once held dreams and ambitions now reflected a deep longing for a life free of suffering. It's a burden to this family, but mainly the mother of those children who has to look after them alone because their father too is sick. He's suffering from a backache problem which can't allow him to do anything. He's now physically challenged after falling down one morning, and to his bad luck, the backbone broke. From that day, he's not able to walk properly except with the use of this rod that helps him to stand or even walk. He also tried going for some treatment, and due to not having too much, he resorted to traditional medicine, where he spent months when they were trying, but all in vain, and their money and period were wasted. Their mother was always crying for help, asking people to support them with money so that these children would be taken to hospitals and they would even know what they were suffering from, then proceed with medication, as they were worried, wondering whether children are having abnormalities or any other health conditions. These children could try to understand what you tell them, but have difficulties in talking, with some stammering issues. But as you can see, it was because they spent a lot of years, more than 20 years locked inside, due to protecting them from people who always brought in some negative vibes, negative comments, and less helpful words that discouraged parents. And for the good of them and their children, they decided to lock them in the house for many years. but according to what we can see, they show signs of improving. If given treatment and formal education, they can become as normal as anyone else. We also couldn't tell exactly what this condition looks like, but it has some similarities with essential tremor. This is a nervous system disorder that causes involuntary and rhythmic shaking. It can affect almost any part of the body. About half of essential tremor cases appear to result from a genetic mutation. If this is really the illness, it is said that there is no cure for essential tremor. However, treatments are available to ease symptoms.
Bakunzi ba Afrimax TV.
We made advocacy for these children, and different Good Samaritans started visiting them and helping. And in a miraculous way, the family got money and took these children to the hospital. The mother thanks and appreciates each and everyone who supported, visited and prayed for them after seeing the situation. People supported with food, money. Some were even around at the hospital, and they were not lonely, says the mother. There are slight changes that shows a great impact compared to when we visited for the very first time. By now, they remember a few things and learned how to count. They even know their names. With newfound hope, this mother was finally able to take her children to the nearest hospital, where doctors and specialists examined them. After numerous tests, the diagnosis was revealed: a rare genetic disorder that had caused their bodies to gradually deteriorate. Although there was no cure, doctors devised a treatment plan to alleviate their symptoms and improve their quality of life. With this, they got a belief that it was just a matter of time until they will start working on their own and go everywhere they want, as the mother says. In comparison with how we saw them first, there is so much faith. Now they can walk, not far, but it's totally different to previous time. They can even hold tight something. If they get more follow-up, it will yield a great improvement. Good Samaritans joined forces and kept visiting this family, as we also came with some people who saw them on Afrimax TV, then felt empathy for these children, hence opting to lend a helping hand. As generous as they are, they did whatever they could. These children are now able to walk on their feet while leaning on something, because their bodies are not that strong enough to support movement and maybe run quickly. But so far, so good, and this mother is grateful. According to their mother, her children had almost recovered, but she got a problem of running out of budget since she was supposed to take them to hospitals once every month. And though she's grateful to what has happened so far, she says they need more support to keep taking them to hospitals. Having seen that the more they visit the hospital, the more her children's condition goes on improving. We can support these children to get advanced treatment and improve their lives by contributing on givinglife.com. Donate and save their lives. In the end, this story became more than just the story of one family's hardships. It became a parable of hope, reminding the world that love and compassion can conquer the darkest of trials. Thank you for watching. I'm Elijah, and this is Afrimax English. Remember to subscribe.